Hi, I'm Kang, and this is Camilla, and we're the 5 Resellers, and we're going to talk about 5 mistakes that we've made, and some that you might be making, and some that we've seen other resellers make as well.
And we're going to tell you how you can avoid these mistakes. The first mistake that we see resellers making is not having a good inventory system. So whatever that means to you, for us, that's bins, you know, that are labeled with numbers and a spreadsheet, a corresponding spreadsheet. That means that when we sell an item, we can actually find it. So we found ourselves in a situation where we can't find an item that we've sold
multiple times.
And then we have to go through all of our bins and all of the different bags of things that we have. So especially if you are moving things from your inventory system, like sometimes we take things to Plato's Closet or other buy sell trade stores, or we put them in boxes here or there, moving things around, things can get lost.
Yeah.
So you wanna really make sure that you are keeping track of exactly where you have your items.
Yeah, otherwise it's just a big waste of time to try to find these things. And if you think about it, a lot of these items are maybe $20 or even $30. That might not be worth your time. If it's obviously a $100 item, you're gonna search for that thing no matter what. But yeah, it's really difficult to try to justify spending half an hour to find a $20 sale or a $30 sale. So, you know, really get your inventory system down and make sure you're not wasting time.
So the next mistake we see a lot of resellers make is not checking comps and not checking the sell-through rate on items when they pick them up. So comps are looking at comparable solds for that item, seeing how much it sold for, but sell-through rate shows you're looking to see how many items are currently listed compared to how many items have sold.
Right.
And you want that comparison to show more solds than currently listed, because that means your item is actually gonna sell. Yeah. So it doesn't do you much good if it's an item that could sell for $100, but there's one sold and 100 listed.
Right.
You might not sell that item. And so you wanna be checking that before you make your purchase, so that you're not buying something based solely on brand or solely on something that you've heard or anything like that, but you're basing it on the data.
Right, and we've made that mistake a lot, especially when we first started out. I thought, oh man, this is really cool, we should pick it up. And I didn't look at the comps. Even if we did look at the comps, I didn't check the sell-through rates. Just like Camilla said, you wanna know what the sell-through rates are, because that'll tell you basically how long you're gonna hold on to this item. And the better the sell-through rate, the faster it'll fly off your shelf.
And one thing that you learn in reselling is if you pick up a lot of things that you just think, wow, this is really cool, I think it will sell, and you don't check those comps, you don't do anything, you kind of find out that you're a unique individual. And you might be the only one who thinks it's really cool.
Right.
So there's only one of you, so you want to make sure that other people have those same interests.
Right.
Okay, so our next mistake that we see people make is not managing their time. So their time in the business. So that includes both the time that you spend listing an item. So you don't want to pick up items that are really low in value, meaning you only make $2, $5, $10 on it, whatever the value to you, whatever that cutoff point is. You don't necessarily want to pick up those low value items because you have to spend a lot of time photographing, listing, inventorying, packing up those items. But on the other hand, when you're outsourcing, you don't want to spend all day, every day sourcing, going to all these different thrift stores, garage sales, and never pick up anything. That's also wasting your time. So you want to balance those two so that you get a good profit per the time that you spend in your business.
And I think that people who have only just started out kind of fall into this, and it's kind of a cycle. And this is the time to break the cycle, because when you pick up old things and you look back and you see that it's not going to make you any money, it feels kind of bad. So now is the time to realize that your time is worth money. There's only a limited amount of it. You know, you can make more money, right? But you should really find out what the value of your time is.
You know, we are not immune to this mistake either. If you watch our What Sold videos, you'll often see us say, oh, we only made a couple dollars on that item. You know, either we had picked it up early on or hadn't noticed the flaw or something. We have those mistakes as well. So don't feel bad if something like that happens to you, or if you've made some bad buys in the past, or if you feel like, oh, I don't know what to do with all of this, I'm not gonna make that much money. Join the club.
Yeah, sometimes you gotta take a loss too, you know? And we've seen a lot of other YouTubers talk about this. People who have done this for years, you know, they are thought of as experts in this reselling world. They make this mistake too, so don't beat yourself up about it, but you do wanna find that balance, like we said, where we're just trying to help you realize the value of your time.
So the next mistake that we see a lot of other people making, and by other people we mean ourselves, is when you sell on multiple platforms, like you sell on eBay and Poshmark, Facebook Marketplace, and you sell an item on one of those platforms, not deleting it from those other platforms, and then it sells again, but you don't have the item anymore.
Right.
So this is a really big problem, because then you have to cancel, and sometimes on those platforms there are penalties for canceling too many orders. And you lose a customer. Like, that person is probably never gonna come back to your store or your page or anything like that, because they had a bad experience with you.
Yeah, and this is something that you should think about even if you're not selling on multiple platforms. You'll probably find yourself selling on at least two platforms at one time or another. We started on Poshmark and we gradually moved to eBay, and even two platforms can be sometimes difficult. And you forget to take an item off one of those platforms just once, and it feels bad because you've gotten and lost a sale. And then sometimes if you're on eBay, that actually really hurts your account. So definitely keep that in mind even if you're not cross-listing to any platforms right now.
So you want to create a system where you are systematically deleting those items from those platforms, whether it's you always do it immediately when it sells, or you do it each night, or at, you know, noon when, you know, the clock tolls, or whatever it is. Make some sort of system that you are deleting those items on a regular basis, so that you don't, you know, here, there, wherever, and you miss some items.
If you're part-time resellers like us, you're not always going to be available. You might not be able to get on your phone to delist or get on the computer. Just do it as soon as you can.
So the next mistake we see a lot of people making, and ourselves included,
yeah,
is letting our emotions get in the way of making a sale. So whether that be pricing something up really high because we have a lot of kind of emotions invested in that item, or it's, you know, getting a lowball offer and feeling really offended by it, or having a person counter back and forth a couple times and being like, "Ugh, I don't want to sell you the item anymore." This even happened to me today. Someone was countering back and forth with me, and I could feel myself getting annoyed because I don't like playing that game. And finally, I just thought, I'll just message this person and tell her my lowest offer. And I did, and I made the sale. And so you really have to remember that you're in the business of making sales, of sending things off. You're not in the business of like making friends on these reselling platforms. That's not the purpose of them. The purpose of them, at least for resellers like us, business people, we want to have a business, you know, and you can't let your emotions rule that each and every day.
Yeah, that's good customer service. That's really what it's about, where you're trying to make the sale because you are trying to be a good customer service representative for your business. So you definitely want to try to keep a cool head and make sure you're trying to make that sale. Always be closing, as they say. And so that means that you're trying to be as nice as you possibly can, because they don't know on the internet what you're feeling unless you show them, right? So you maybe just need to take a step back and really just let yourself cool down. If, you know, that's the best way to do it, then so be it. You just need to pause, put the phone down, or just close out the web browser and just take a step back for a little bit and see if there's a way to try to close that deal.
Before we give our bonus tip for you, if you've made any of these mistakes, let us know down in the comments, or if you feel like there was one that you've made that you really want to warn other people against, put it down in the comments so that, you know, that can be a place of learning, so that we can see all the different ways that, you know, we've failed in our life, because we all fail. So
we want to hear your stories. So let us know in the comments for sure.
Yeah. And if you liked this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure that you are subscribed so you can join our community. We make lots of reselling videos, like hauls and what sold videos, and lots of these tips and trick videos. So if you are interested in that, make sure that you're subscribed so that you can be part of our little squad on the internet.
So the bonus tip is, don't be too hard on yourself. I think that when we make mistakes, we tend to beat ourselves up. We're often a little too hard on ourselves, and we're sometimes our harshest critics.
Yeah, and especially when you are comparing yourselves to other resellers' social media feeds rather than their real life, you're comparing your real life to their social media, you can feel like you might be the only one who's done this, or that your business is not doing well because of these mistakes. But you know what? We've all been there and we're still there pretty much. So don't feel like you have to be this perfect reseller to be a really great one.
Right. And I keep telling us, when we make mistakes, is that it's not the first time we've made a mistake, and it's certainly not the last time we're gonna make a mistake. And that's the truth of the matter. And that means that if you ever want someone to just cheer you on come back to this video and watch it because we are rooting for you. We'll see you later.
Bye.